Welcome everyone to our new webinar dedicated to performer. A question for you guys, girls. Your SAP data knows more about you. Well, subjects. And today we've got two amazing speakers to answer these questions and to help you to define how to make the most of your data and how to improve your SAP system thanks to the data. We've got on the floor Dr. Tamás Sierches. Hello, Tamás. Thank you for being there with us.
Hi, everyone.
Welcome, welcome. And we also have York. Hello, York. Welcome in the call. Thank you for sharing your expertise and experience. They will give you in a few seconds more details about their knowledge and geography. But let me share with you few details to make the most of this webinar. First, this is a 45 minutes webinar. Do not hesitate to ask your questions to our experts. And please, please, to make the most of these presentations, use Google Chrome, because with some other browsers, you maybe will have some issues with sounds and image. Okay, so if you're not on Google Chrome, quit, come back, refresh. This webinar is made for you. So do not hesitate to ask all your questions to our experts. Top right of the screen of the room, you have the chat. This is the best way to ask all your questions. I will be the moderator today. I will ask the question for you. We also prepare for you a poll with few questions to help us make our webinars even better days after day, so do not hesitate also to take few minutes, few seconds, because there are only a few questions to help us improving our presentations. Tamás, Jörg, I give you the floor. I wish you all a nice presentations and see you for the Q&A session.
Thank you very much, Pierre. Thank you for the introduction. Shall I start, Tamás, with quickly introducing myself?
Yep, sounds good.
Yeah. Okay, so my name is Jörg Zets. I started in IT, I think it was 2008, so quite a while ago. And I've always had a focus on ERP. And in the early days, I focused on Microsoft ERP. But already since 2010, I am I'm within the SAP family, so to say. With a clear focus on optimizing business processes for our customers. Tamás?
Yep. So I've been for more than 20 years, actually 23 years now, in the SAP business. At SOA People, I'm responsible for innovation, which covers all the process improvements the customers can do thanks to new technologies. So I think today's webinar is exactly about this topic. Besides that, I'm an SAP mentor, which is a small group of experts globally recognized by SAP, distinguished engineer, and I'm also active in the Dutch community as the chairman of the VNSK User Experience Focus Group.
Yeah. Okay, we are both quite excited about the tool that we're going to talk about, Tamás, Performer. Because like I said, we both focus on optimizing business processes, and I think this tool can really work, or really works for our customers. And today we're going to talk about, of course, customers that are already using SAP and how this tool can work for them to prioritize projects, to see what the value is of their current system, and how they can get more out of the investment that they made in SAP. So when we look at the agenda, because there are quite a few participants, and I see I've seen some registrants that are familiar with SOA People, but there are also some that are less familiar. So we start with a very short introduction. I will use two slides to explain a little bit more about the company SOA People, who we are and what we do, and then we jump directly into the subject of today, Performer. And we will do so with starting to tell you more about value management, value management for SAP, and what does this mean? And then, of course, we come with very concrete examples. But I feel that you are really also looking forward to a demonstration, of course, and we will do so. Tomas will definitely demonstrate Performer. And like our colleague Pierre has explained, please don't hesitate to ask any questions during the webinar. You can do so in the chat, but also after the webinar, there is some time, of course, for questions and answers. So this is the agenda. Like Pierre said, we think it will take 45 minutes in total. Would you like to add something, Tomas, or shall I just jump into the introduction?
No, it's perfect. We can start.
Okay. Well, SOA people, we are a leading consulting and services group specializing in SAP solutions. And if you look at where we are located, we have regional offices in 6 European countries. We are in the Netherlands, Belgium, Luxembourg, France, Germany, and Switzerland. You can see this, of course, on the picture in orange. But we are also one of the biggest players when it comes to a pure focus on SAP, because we have 100% dedicated focus on SAP software. And we do this with more than 600 SAP experts, over 900 customers that we have in the group. And the table below shows the steady growth that we have gone through since the start in 2008. And where we are today in 2021, and even last year in this heavy crisis, we had a very good year, and we can still show some growth. So this is the first slide, and I've got just one more slide about SOA people, but because I think this is also an important slide to see, okay, what do we do then? How do we help our customers? On this slide, you see the four. Yeah, let's say the services pillars of SOA people, from left to right, ready to business, ready to perform, ready to innovate, and ready to support. With ready to business, we have a focus on the pre-configured vertical solutions, the template solutions for different industries. We have a solution, for example, for the service and maintenance industry. With the second services pillar, ready to perform, we help our customers optimizing existing SAP environments. So where you see on the left that we also do the greenfield implementations of SAP S/4HANA, you see with the second services pillar, we really focus on optimizing existing environments. The third pillar, ready to innovate, has of course a focus on all the innovations. The innovations go really quick. Since 2000, where we were standing in 2010 when I started working for SOA people and where we stand today, there's a huge difference with what is possible. Of course, the move from E2C to S/4HANA, and I'm only now talking about SAP innovations, but also the SAP cloud platform, SAP Leonardo, and SAP likes to change the names as well, so there are lots of name changes over the years, but the innovations go very, very rapidly, and for our customers it's not always clear what innovations they should adapt and what innovations they shouldn't, because it's not too interesting for their business, for their company, etc. But from our ready to innovate services pillar, we help our customers in deciding what innovations they should want to know more about and to adapt, and which ones are not too interested. And also within our ready to innovate pillar, we have got our own IP, our own products that we're very proud of and that are an addition to the standard SAP software. And one of the products is the product that we talk about today, is Performer. Now, last but not least, on the right of the slide, you see ready to support, and that is our offering for helping our customers with the functional, the technical support of their SAP solution, with private cloud hosting, I would like to say the whole shebang, everything that has to do with the support, we offer on the right side of the slide, it says ready to support. And with these four services pillars, we can support our customers during the complete IT lifecycle of their solution. So from the first implementation all the way up to the day-to-day 24/7 support that comes with this. It was a very, very short introduction, just 2 slides. But I can imagine that you might have some questions. please put them in the chat or ask them during the Q&A. I think it's good to move to a performer and the reason why we are here today. And I would like to start always with why. Why is a performer an interesting application? What are the questions that our customers have when they decide to go for Infotool Performer, to implement Performer, to purchase Performer? And these are questions that I have heard already for a very long time. Since I started in 2008, a lot of these questions were already there, and they are still there. Questions like, our SAP solution has not delivered all the benefits that we expected. Or are we using everything, all the possibilities? Are we using, are we fully leveraging all this SAP capabilities? The lots of investments into the licenses, and are we getting out of it as much as we can? Or what projects should we do to optimize? What and how do we prioritize these projects? And what is our return of investment? And of course, over the last few years, or since I think let's see, it's now 2021, maybe since 2019, I get also questions like, how can we assess the real business value of investing in SAP S/4HANA? So besides knowing that ECC will at one point run out of support, what is the real business value of SAP S/4HANA? And these questions are all related to value management. How can we value the investment that we have made, that we have done in SAP? And 99, this my in my experience, and please, Tomas, if you would like to add something, do so. But in my experience, 99% of the companies that use SAP are not able to really value their use of the software. And this is the power of Performer. And this is what we're going to jump to, of course. And this is what later on Tomas will show, how Performer can help you in valuing your investment in SAP. Okay. And what is Performer then? I mean, I was talking about the questions that companies have and why our customers implement Performer. But what is Performer? Well, Performer is an automated subscription-based cloud platform, and it gives you the capabilities to continuously measure your performance. So I just explained why our customers purchase the software, why they implement Performer, and the questions that they have, and the answers that you can get with Performer. But what is Performer? What kind of solution is it? Well, Performer is an automated subscription-based cloud platform, and it gives you the capabilities to continuously measure your performance. And besides that, it also helps you to prioritize your business and to prioritize the projects that you should put high on the calendar and that are less interesting. And you can do this really based on actual facts. So it's not like, how do you say, in Dutch we say, not the fingerwerk. It's actually based on actual numbers. Okay. Measuring the value of your SAP solution is not a one-time thing. We believe that you should really want to do this continuously. So it's not a one-time assessment, but you want to see in time if it really brings the value that you have forecasted. And that's why we definitely see this as a process, as a continuous process. That's the power of Performer. It all starts with what we call the value assessment. When you look back in the historical data to see what processes you are performing really well in, on what KPIs, you perform really well, really good, but also to see what processes, what KPIs you're performing less good in. And based on this assessment, Performer makes a strategy planning. Performer can make business cases. So it tells you what KPIs you should want to optimize. And not only this, it also tells you what kind of investment you need to make to optimize these processes? And just as important, what is the return on investment on these optimizations? And last but not least, like I said, the power of this tool is the continuous valuing. You can also measure this in time. So let's say you're six months ahead, then it's very important that you can measure if what you have forecasted, if what you have prognosed, if this has really come out. And this is, I think, the strength, basically the strength of Performer. So it's the continuously performing the value of your SAP instance. Tomas, I think I've said something about why customers should want to consider Performer. The answers that you get when you run the tool, the solution. And I would like now to ask you to tell something about how can Performer do this? So what is the power then of Performer? Like, how are we able? How is Performer able to help the customers with these questions that they have? Do you want to tell something about the tool Performer and how it works?
Yeah, please. Let me do that. So now I will explain how it actually works. And maybe it's a little bit abstract, but right after this, I will give a live demo. So then you will see it really in action. I will follow exactly the steps you described in the system. But okay, how do we do it first? So the starting point is your data, your own real actual business data in your SAP backend system. So, which is in SAP tables, standard SAP tables, or custom tables and function modules. We extract that data with SAP extractors. So the extractors themselves are coming from SAP, which means that they are reliable, trustable, no question about what they do. And we extract some hundred tables to our Performer platform. And that means all the analysis we do is based on your actual business data. That's different. There are some other approaches on the market, and they work with surveys and you know, more softer data. This is hard data. It's absolutely your own data from your system. So no feelings, no political aspects are involved, actual just facts. Jörg, could you please continue? Then from this data, 2,700 KPIs are calculated on the fly. So this is really the intelligence in the platform. These KPIs cover business and IT and security aspects. Really, as you can imagine, with 270 KPIs, we can cover a big amount of ground there. And these KPIs are calculated based on a standard definition of the KPI. Again, the power is that you get insight in your own business in a very transparent way, no discussions, all just real facts. Then, based on some artificial intelligence and peer data, no, because of course we have done it hundreds of times already, we are able to compare your KPIs with industry peers. We can see how you measure against similar companies, similar business, and also enhance that with artificial intelligence. And based on that, the next step is that we are able to present you an action plan. So Jörg, if you please click there. And here I'm giving the example of SAP RPA, robotic process automation. I'm doing that because that's a very hot topic. We get a lot of questions about that. But it could be anything. No, it could be that you want to improve in finance, in logistics. As I mentioned, with the 2,700 KPIs, you cover a lot. But basically, the system creates an action plan for you. I will show you in 2 minutes in the live system, and you can decide on your investment portfolio. You can decide. You can see all the options the system suggests you. You can sort them, prioritize them. You can also build your business case so that you can make a good decision where to invest in which process improvements which process improvements are worth to for your investment. And then the next step is that you actually do the process improvements, and then you can go back and measure your performance again against the same KPIs which you defined. By the way, you can also personalize these KPIs for your needs, and then you can track the progress. So actually three simple steps, as Jorg explained on the previous slide. First, you do an assessment where you are today, and of course compare you against the peers. Then you actually do some improvements, and then you go back and measure it again. You see how you perform in the end. And then of course it's a continuous cycle, because it's not one improvement and then you are done forever, no, but it's a continuous process which we support here.
And Tomas, I visit lots of customers, of course, and I always get the same questions when it comes to the data extraction. And it's always like, how safe is it, Tomas? I mean, it's a cloud tool, a performer. Yeah. How safe is it to extract this data to this cloud platform?
Well, as I said, no, the tool we use is actually from SAP. So we by the way, App Performer itself is also running in the SAP cloud. So we are using a lot of standard, and it's using HANA. And so we're using a lot of standard SAP technology, which I hope SAP customers trust. So there is no real, you know, suspicious items in this.
Okay. And another question that I often get is about the business case. Is this like an automated business case? I mean, does Performer make the business case, or do our customers have to make this business case themselves based on the outcome of Performer? How does it work?
The value is automatically calculated based on the engines I was explained. For the cost aspect, it makes a recommendation. But the good thing is that as a customer, you can always go back and you can review all the aspects of the business case, and you can adjust them. You can say that, oh no, maybe for example, my labor costs are higher than what the Performer thinks for the geography and industry. Or maybe you know, any specific aspects of your business, you will see all the details of the business case, and you can modify them, and then of course it's automatically updated.
And one more question that's related to the benchmarking capabilities, eh? But like you said, with the peers, peer customers, like how much data is in Performer then? Are we talking about 10 customers or 100, or how much data is in Performer? Who are the peers? How many companies are these?
Yeah, so I think around 400-500 customers are in the system. And what I would like to emphasize, that these are data from real customers, real data, no? So not just some kind of analyst information or surveys which you all know are biased, no? This is you know, just pure facts.
Okay. I believe that we are all waiting now for the presentation, Tomas, or for a demonstration. What do you want to do? Do you want to demo the system straight away, or do you want to use some slides first? What is your suggestion?
No slides. We go into the real system directly.
Okay.
So cool. Here it is. What you see here is Performer, right? So imagine as a customer, we already extracted your data, then this is the first page you see, and actually this is the first page you see. So here you see a general index, which is your overall company score, and then you can drill down to three aspects which we call fast, safe, and cost effective. So fast is all about the business value and how you can achieve business value faster in a more agile way using innovations. Safe has a lot to do with IT aspects and security and business continuity. And then, of course, I mentioned there is always the cost side of the house, which you manage here. So What I will do is show you some parts of Performer. I cannot show you everything in this webinar. As you can imagine, it's a complex platform with a lot of screens and a lot of possibilities to drill down and analyze data. So I will just give you a high level overview, but I will walk through all the steps which Jörg presented. So I will show you the KPIs. I will show you how you can answer some of these questions about what is actually the value of your SAP system. I will show you how you make decisions, how you decide which priorities are high and where you put your investment into process improvements. And I will show you finally the third step is how you track your progress. So let's start. Let's start with the FAST. And I will show you the part which I think the most exciting is about business process application performance. So here we talk about finance, logistics, HR, you know, all your main processes. And if you click here, you will see exactly customer specific data. So these are some of your big processes like order to cash, procure to pay, and so on. And you don't see everything here because this is specific to a customer. No? So this customer has these processes. In your case, it could be, you know, maybe some other ones as well, or you know, a completely other set. What you already see here on the left is already a benchmark on this very highly aggregated level, but we can, of course, drill down. So I will click on order to cash. You see already sub-processes here. And then I will go to sales orders. And here you see some of the KPIs. Now each KPI has a code because we have a whole library of KPIs. So you can go and look up the precise definition. Of course, has a description. And there is a value. Value is the most important, of course, about the KPI. And the KPI values can be different things. It could be just a number of items, no? Like how many sales orders you have, for example. But it could also be a business value. So, for example, amount, sales order documents, and this is expressed in euros. Or it can be a percentage, no? Where it's interesting to see a trend. So this is very powerful. I think...
So these are just a few of the KPIs out of the 2,700.
Yes,
that's
yes.
Very important to emphasize, I think. These are just, I mean, on this screen I see only 20 or something KPIs, but there are 2,700 in the system, is it true?
Yeah, exactly. So, of course, so this is a long list and I can open many more items and I'm only in the area of business process application performance, and even inside there I'm only in the area of FAST, so you can imagine like a big tree here. And I'm only sure one little branch of the big tree. But yeah, and what is interesting here is these different types of KPIs, because we not only measure the number of documents. There are many tools on the market, maybe process mining type of tools, which only show, let's say, the number of items. But here we really have a business focus. So if we are talking about the value, so percentages and euro values. So that's really want to emphasize. Also the time period. We are looking at an average 18 months of data. So that's really, really a lot and significant amount of data which we use to make the analysis. All right, then let me jump to another area where I will show you how you see some data about your overall SAP system and how you can appreciate what you do in your SAP. So for that, I go to Diagnose and the 360 Business View. And this is again just a little example. I could click further and show you many more things, but this is an example view, what you see, what amount of information, what amount of data, what amount of a business value, again in euros, go through your SAP systems in the different areas, here in case logistics, marketing and procurement. And you know, this is something you can very well communicate to decision makers, high decision makers, about what is really happening in your system. And again, I could go deeper, but I just want to give the highlights today. Then, okay, we talked about KPIs, we talked about values, okay, you see that. But of course, to make a business case, you also need to look at costs. So you want to understand how you can control or manage your costs. And of course, you want to compare your budget to your peers, because that's also important. So for that, I will go home, back to home, and I will go to the area of cost effective, how we call it. And as you see, there are different types of costs, IT costs, business costs, and other things more related about the services you provide. I will go to the business costs. Yeah.
So I see some colors. I mean, I see a yellow, red, green, like a real dashboard. I see quality of services is now in green, and you want to pick on business costs, and that is in red. Does it say something? I know, but maybe explain a little bit more about what these colors do, and can customers customize it, or how does it work?
Yeah, indeed. So this is like an overall score calculated from all the underlying KPIs. And you can customize that, which KPIs you want to use, because maybe from this 2,700, you think that now not all is relevant for you. So you can then kind of exclude them. So you can do that all that on a very fine level. And in the end, this is a high level number, which maybe doesn't say that much until you actually click on it, and then you go down into the details. But you can see these scores from the lowest level to the highest level, and that's interesting. You can find exactly where you deviate from where you expect to be, no? in terms of the benchmark. So now I'm at the area of costs. And then again, I will go to order to cash. And then what you see here, these are costs which the system recommends based on the data it has and based on the predictions it makes. But I can go and change them. No, I can say that, for example, of number of users creating sales orders, I can, of course, change that. Now, in my case, that's not the case. It's a bigger or a smaller number. And that's how that this, of course, goes back to the business case. All right. So what we did so far, we looked at what we call the value assessment. Now I will go to what we call the strategic planning. So now you are not only looking at where I am, but you want to actually decide what to do based on all this information. So based on facts, you want to identify what are your best candidates for business process improvements. You want to discover quick wins to generate value on the short term and or even the long term. You want to design or shape your transformation journey. So for that, I will go into the area of simulate and business scenario. What you see here is on top of most of the pages, there is an action plan editor. So I will open that. This is an action plan the system is recommending me. So based on my data, it is telling me what I should do. And then, of course, it's up to me as a intelligence educated business user to make my choice. I will give you an example. And again, I will go into the RPA just because we already talked about RPA, and I know it's very interesting for many people. So it is telling me that with robotic process automation, I can automate my invoice processing. And it is telling me what kind of improvements, potential improvements I can achieve with introducing this step. And it is telling me in a lot of details. So, for example, how many percent or just suppliers are paid late. And then in this case, if I do this improvement, then 67% will be paid. So let's say 67% less will be paid late, which is a good thing. We want to pay them on time and so on. It also gives you the savings. So you have a very clear story which you can tell your management about why it makes sense to do this innovation. And if you want to know, okay, but how I come to these numbers, You can see all the KPIs behind it. You can see all the assumptions behind it. You can always change anything if you think that in your case it's a little bit different, and then it goes back and it gets updated here. So you have this whole really, really big decision support here. But my favorite is actually is this graphical view. I can make it bigger because here I can drill in and navigate this whole in a very nicely graphical view, and I can compare the different improvement ideas in this what we call a magic quadrant, where you see that the different initiatives require a different investment and they require a different time duration. But you can nicely compare them by in this graphical way. And of course, here is the next step, which you see on the screen, that I can go ahead and build my business case. But I'm not going to do that because, as I mentioned, there are many ways to navigate in the system, which I cannot show you now in this time. But I think you get the idea that now we could make some strategic choices about where to invest them. And now I'm coming to my third step, is that you want to look at the value you realize. So imagine we implemented this invoice scanning thanks to RPA, take that example, and maybe a few other things. So now you are curious, did we actually achieve the saving which the system calculated? Did we really deliver the benefits as expected? And we want to see it based on facts again. No? And this is very powerful. To be honest, I think there are very, very few organizations in the world who can work this organized. A lot of times, big business plans are created, and then when they are executed, then it's not even sure how exactly they delivered on the premises. But here, everything is black and white. So for that, I will go to the diagnose and the area of fast, and now I will go to time to market just to show you something different. And okay, I could drill down, as you said, many ways, but now I will show you something a little bit more technical, just that you see that it's not only about finance and logistics, but also many technical areas as well. So here we are talking about a technical but important area, that you have transports in your SAP system, and we also analyze this is as it's part of release management, and it indicates how fast you are able to react to the business requirements. No, because some business requirements are eventually translated into some technical solutions in your system, and those solutions have to flow through your landscape from development to production. And analyzing that, how efficient you are in release management, is an important thing. No? That eventually impacts how. Yeah, your time to market, as it says. So here you see the trends again throughout all these KPIs, and if you can click on a trend, and you can see how you improve time-wise in this area, which is now about how many days you need to release changes, transports to your system. Okay. Now I can also do, to make it even nicer, I can see what I can track my projects, because yes, we defined some projects. And I'm not going to show you the invoice processing, because in this view it's still at 0%, but I can see that our master data cleansing the project is already finished. So that's nice. Then let's look into that. And then, okay, I see the milestones as I plan the project, and I see the actual savings achieved as measured in the system based on your own in ERP system. So I can really go back and say that, okay, I was recommended to do a master data cleansing. I did that, and I'm happy to report that we achieved so much saving with this initiative, and how it is underpinned by the different KPIs and how the different KPIs improved in this project. And I can see that not everything is perfect, because that's reality in life. No, you cannot improve everything. So I can see again that, okay, even though we delivered a lot of value, there are areas where I could still do better. So you can continue the analysis and you know, enjoy performance management in a continuous basis.
So thanks a lot. Thanks, Tamás and Jörg, for this first part of the presentations. Right on time, sharp on time to start the Q&A sessions. We do hope that these presentations suits you. Let's make a short wrap-up, I would say, to summarize what's in it for you, what's the best of these solutions to solve or to help make you successful with your challenges. And jump in the Q&A session. I see some of them in the chat that could be really interesting to start the Q&A sessions. Maybe Tamás, would you like to start, or Jörg?
Yeah, thank you, Pierre. Thank you. It's always very nice to see the demo, I have to say, because when you see, you can hear a lot about the solution, but with the demo of Tamás, it really makes sense. Eh? You really see things happening. And so, yeah, it was a very good demo, Tamás. Thank you for that. On this slide you see the overall benefits of the tool, but maybe it's even a little bit more interesting, Tamás, if you can say something about the Performant tool and how it compares to other tools that are available in the market. You know what I mean? So what is the difference, the big difference between Performer and the tools that are available either by SAP or other vendors?
Well, it's a good question, and actually it's almost a follow-up to one of the questions in the chat. So there are actually not a lot of options on the market. We believe we are quite unique with this. Yes, indeed, SAP has actually multiple tools, and that's already one of the points, that they have multiple not integrated tools which can be used, and we also suggest them to use, you know, so they are not competing, as I'm saying. The big power of Performer is the fact that it's based on facts, you know? So we really, everything what we do in the platform is based on your data, on customers' data, and the others don't do that, no? The others work on secondary information, no? So based on survey, based on reference stories and all that. And we all know that those are, let's say, not 100% precise. So this is a key point here. And maybe the second point I could mention is also the coverage, no? 2,700 KPIs, it's very broad. It's not only business-oriented KPIs, but also IT-related things regarding security, access, audit, which many times it's almost like another software, but here it's covered that aspect as well. And I think that the complete approach, which is mentioned here. So you start with the KPIs, and then you get the recommendations, you build business cases, you continuously monitor it. So that whole cycle is there. And a lot of times people ask, and then we'll let you continue. A lot of people nowadays ask, because of course we all know that SAP acquired Signavio. No, it's the big news. Last week they actually completed the acquisition. So a lot of times people ask, like, hey, is it the same, or is it competing? And not at all, because Signavio is very strong in process modeling, in process mining, in the process analysis, really deep into that. And we are we have another purpose, no? Our purpose is the value management, no? To identify improvement and to measure the value of your projects and of your whole SAP investment. So they are, in this sense, they are Signavio, I would say, is complementary to what we do.
Okay. And one of the things that I really like about our tool is that our customers use it to continuously track the value of their SAP system. Is this also something that you see, Thomas? And how do you value this? I mean, when you compare it to other tools and the strength of Performer?
Yeah, indeed. So this is some tools have this vision, but for us this is the reality. No, that this is the whole purpose of Performer. You can use it as a one-time scan, but then you are missing the whole value, no? Because the whole point is that a lot of companies make the effort of developing a business case, and once the business case looks good, yeah, then they actually start the project. But most of the time, they never come back to the original business case and reevaluate it, learn from it, improve it. That is often not done because you are missing data really to do that.
Yeah.
So if you skip that step, well, then you skip a big part of the value.
Yeah, that's what I see very often. And that it gets harder and harder to convince the upper management to do these projects if you can't prove that the value was really the value that was achieved was really the value that was expected in the previous projects, eh? so that's why I really think that this is a huge strength of Performer as well. I've seen quite a few questions, I have to say. I'm really happy to see that the chat is really alive, you know. There are really lots of people asking questions. Many of them were already answered by Thomas. Thank you for that.
I've got one from Amy. Let's start with her. How often your customers are updating the analysis? I think that it links to what you just say, York, the value management, I would say, and to get a picture of the reality at a D time, I would say, at a D day, but also to improve the processes. Could you just answer Amy on this topic?
Yeah, so that's true, eh? like Thomas said, and like you are explaining right now, this is something that depends, of course, on the customer, but what we see is that they do this much more often than twice or three times a year. So like a monthly or a quarterly thing to do is to check and to see and to track the value and to see what happened with the projects that went live, etc., etc. So in it depends on the customer, it depends on the company, but definitely multiple times a year, I would say. So monthly or quarterly.
Thanks for that. That's your for your answer. I hope, Amy, that it answers your questions. I got one from Jordi. Will the data of our company be used for benchmarking? How does that actually work?
Of course, it's all unanimous, no? So you don't see actual customer names and references, no? It's not like a reference database, which of course those things also exist. No, it's really just about abstract numbers, and in the benchmark, you don't find any company name or any sensitive information. We don't expose the members of the benchmark.
Thanks for that, Thomas. Any other questions for our experts? We're running not out of time. We have a few more minutes, so do not hesitate to ask a question if you have some more. But what, maybe Hervé, try to share something with us. Be our guest. From Hervé, what is the advantage compared to BSR?
Okay. So let me start with what is BSR, because maybe it's not clear for everyone. So BSR is an SAP service, I would say, as a business scenario recommendation. So the idea is that you run some SAP nodes in your system, and it produces a file. That file you upload to an SAP website, and in 5 business days, SAP sends you a PDF, which talks about some benefits of S/4HANA. So right there, there is already a difference, because BSR is about S/4HANA, and we are talking about value from your SAP system. Yes, S/4HANA, we believe, is a good thing, which does bring extra value, but we are not here to sell you S/4HANA or anything like that. So that's one thing. BSR, as of today, is limited to 6 lines of business. There are more, obviously, but so we support all. BSR is limited to 6. BSR is not there to go drill down into information. No, it's a PDF. No, you cannot drill down. If you nowadays SAP is investing some other tools which give some more details, but they are not integrated. So okay, but BSR itself, you cannot drill down. You cannot. You don't have the functionality to build a business case. You cannot monitor your progress. You cannot do continuous performance improvement because it's a PDF you get and that's it. You know? So it is a good thing, to be honest. You know, we sometimes advise customers to make use of it as a small additional benefit, I would say, but it's nowhere comparable to performance.
Thanks, Thomas, for this answer. Any other questions yet? No big deal. You know, we are here for you to help you succeed. You have under your haze my thanks. Thanks, Hervé. We hope we answered your questions. This is my contact. Do not hesitate to send me your question. If you have more, I will send them to Thomas, Jörg, to the team involved. I would like really to thank you, Thomas and Jörg, for the quality of this presentation. So thanks for that. But thank you also, dear participants, for your presence here and for these dynamic discussions, interactions we had during this webinar. This really makes sense for us. That means that this is a topic that clinked in your minds. But so do not forget that we are all here to help you meet and win your challenges. So see you soon. Thanks a lot. Do not hesitate to come back to us, and we wish you a wonderful afternoon. See you soon.